Hey, welcome back to Basics in Farming course. Today we're going to talk about one of the most critical topics in farming. It's called humus. It's not your hummus spread on the bread. It's humus, H-U-M-U-S. I've come across many farmers with whom I try to discuss about this, and some of them didn't even know what is humus. See, when I was working in my farm in California, I had some areas of the farm tested for soil organic matter content. And some numbers came out to 8.2. This is because I have been dumping compost in those places in huge quantities without even measuring how much I actually dumped. And when I started thinking, what does this 8.2% soil organic matter means? I realized that if you take 100 kg of soil, 8.2 kgs is going to be composed of the following, which is the bacteria and the fungi and the other living organisms in the soil, the dead and the decaying matter in the soil, and the completely decayed matter that is very useful for the soil, and it has a lot of properties that will improve the soil, and also this strange thing called humus, right? And I wondered, how do I measure how much humus is there? What is the formula for humus? Okay, and how do I know that the soil is full of humus, other than the signs that the plants are showing to be very, very healthy and shiny and productive? And I realized that it is impossible to find humus. So it's a magical substance. It's like the ghost, right? So you cannot find it. But you can, it reveals itself by phenomenal soil health. That's how it reveals itself. Scientists have been trying to find the actual formula for humus, and there is no formula. And whenever clay combines with a lot of organic matter, magic happens in the soil through the activities of several microorganisms, and humus is formed. And one way to measure the humic content of soil is to find out what is the cation exchange capacity in the soil and any compost you make. If you make a good compost, and if you can find a way to bring the cation exchange capacity above 80+, then it is a good compost, which means when you composted it, you ensured that the humification process was happening properly. And typically when you mix that compost into your soil, if your soil reaches cation exchange capacity of let's say 30 milliequivalents, then that soil is extremely healthy. The challenge I see is many farmers don't measure these things, but work very hard, put all their energy into their soil and expect results, and feel extremely sad if the results don't come. When your foundation is not good, the building you build on top is going to fall apart. So the foundation for any soil is humus. And remember, when you till the soil a lot, you're going to destroy the humus you have built. So I recommend no tillage or minimum tillage for all farming practices. Tillage actually means plowing. Don't plow your soil too much. For vegetables, I recommend plowing twice a year, very shallow, 4 inches. For fruits, don't plow at all, other than for throwing perennial cover crops around the tree, for growing them and mulching them. For tree-based orchards, strong recommendation is to mulch it with as much cover crops that you can grow around the trees. Cover crops are what I mean as green manure. So soil humification is the fundamental goal of every farmer. And we will go in great depth into humus and humus formation in the advanced course. Thank you.